everyone. Welcome to the presentation for the Daily FX audience entitled How to Improve the Timing of Your Trades Using Oscillators. Now, this presentation is going to be part PowerPoint, but mostly live data. And I'm not going to go through hundreds of years worth of charts to find the two or three that make me look smart. I'm simply going to go into the live data on the FXCM MT4 platform and show you what has just been happening in the last couple of hours and apply the strategies using these oscillators to the real market. Okay, so here we go. Now, let me remind you that the purpose of this presentation is education. There are no trade recommendations. However, I am here to conduct technical analysis, teach you how to put together trade plans throughout the day. Do not trade real money until you have a track record of success. It's common sense to know that trading and investing is risky business, but Forex is unique because you're leveraged 100 to 1 or even quite a bit more. As an amateur trader, once in a while you may get lucky and that leverage will work for you, but more often than not it will work against you. Do not trade real money until you have a track record of success using a demo account. My name is Wayne McDonald. I'm the chief currency coach of FXBootcamp.com. I'm also a commodities trading advisor, which means the NFA has deemed me an expert in fundamental and technical analysis. You can learn more about my company by going to FXBootcamp.com. It simply is a live training organization, over 12 hours a day. We teach you how to create your own trade plans, teach you how to understand the technical and fundamental and psychological aspects of trading Forex. And again, we teach you while the market's moving in real time. A lot of the concepts that are in this presentation are also in my book, The Strategic and Tactical Forex Trading, and that is available on Amazon.com. If you're interested in both FX Bootcamp or the book, I leave it to you to go out and find them. Let's go through the chart setup here. What I'm going to do is break down price action and money action. Okay, or I should say price action and market action. My goal is to always to line the two up so that we have the greater chance of success. It's sort of like, go with the flow. Well, water always finds the path of least resistance, so that's what I want to do. It's my goal not to beat the market. My goal is to be a cork in the river of life and just flow with the market, and that's why I need to line up price action with market action. I do this using moving averages, but also do this with oscillators. I'm going to show you how to use the oscillators. Just a brief breakdown on how to understand my charts. I use a 2155 EMA to understand the direction of the market. And its pace. I also use the 5 and the 8 EMA SMA combination to identify price action and its sort of its momentum. I use 200 EMA to identify the long-term trend. I use Bollinger Bands as a measure of volatility at the two standard deviations. And then, of course, the stars today are the oscillators. Okay, I use a MACD with custom settings set at 21, 55, and 8. And I use stochastics set at 835. Now, there is a common denominator here, isn't it? It's Fibonacci ratios. All of these settings, or the vast majority of these settings, are all based on Fibonacci, and there is a harmony between the two. And if that brings you confidence, then so be it. So here's what market action would look like to me using moving averages. Clearly, the 21 has dropped below the 55. And what we're looking for is opportunities to short. An opportunity short would be things like when price action is also falling. And I measure that with the 5.8. And then, of course, that's a standard chart layout that we're using. What we're focused on in this presentation is how I use these oscillators. The top one is a MACD, and the bottom one is the stochastics. Now, what I'm going to teach you in greater detail is, when to see something like this, which gives you an indication that price is going to fall, and then, this is an opportunity to sell, which is about here. Right in here is an opportunity to sell, right about here. And then all of a sudden we don't get a lower low, and the series of lower highs and lower lows is over. So there's that one MACD cross actually set up to stochastic shorts. Okay, so let's go into this into greater detail. Using the live market. Okay, so you get it? All right, what I want to show you is the represents overbought and oversold conditions for the market. Okay, the market. Now, the market can fall, but price can still rise while the market's falling, right? Think of it this way. You could say to yourself, what's the market going to do today? Let's say you were looking at hourly candles or four-hour candles. You can say to yourself, the market today was up or the market today was down, right? It's one of those things. There's this larger move. Well, even if the market's down today, we understand that the definition of a downtrend is a series of higher highs and higher lows. So a downtrend, let's say for price, could be a series of lower, here's a high, and then there's a low, and then there's a lower high, and then a lower low, and then a lower high, and a lower low, right? But generally speaking, even though price is up and down, the market was down all day, all right? Now, let's apply that to an oscillator, okay? Here's an oscillator here. This is the MACD cross. Now remember, I slowed MACD down, 21.55.8. I slow it down because I don't want it to cross very often. I just want it to show me the direction now, right? Just like, hey, this is telling me, hey, the market is overbought, and that because it's overbought, it's going to want to return to a harmonious level, right? Let's say a fair market value, and that a fair market value would be represented by this waterline on the histogram. But, you know, is price fair? You know, is Forex ever really fair? Very, very few and far between will you find times when price is fair. It's either, you know, it's either too expensive or, like down in here, too cheap, okay? When it's too expensive, then people start to sell. When it's too cheap, people start to buy, right? Just think about it. You were taught, probably when you're learning your ABCs, you were taught to buy low and sell high. You've probably known that in your entire life. You want to buy low and sell high. Well, it gets to a point where, you know, the market's too high and it wants to fall. And then when it falls too far, then people want to buy it again, right? When this is the waterline, what I sort of call in this case fair market value. Well, in this case, MACD has told us that it's way oversold, it's way above the waterline, so to me this is an extreme cross, and that it's beginning to fall. Now, as soon as it crosses down, you're looking for technical reasons to short. Technical reasons to short. All right, we're looking at today's Aussie dollar versus US dollar. Somewhere in here, I'm not even looking at the candles. Okay, I don't even need to see price action. All right, what I'm looking at here is the MACD crossing, and it tells me that in this scenario, the market is overbought and wants to fall back at least to the waterline, and if we're lucky, even farther. So now, what I want to do is create trade plans based on shorting. See, I want to sell when the market's falling. Well, what can I use to measure overbought and oversold conditions of price action? Well, hey, fantastic question. Why don't we use the stochastics? Okay, that's exactly what I'm looking for. So you notice that stochastic crossed here right about when the MACD crossed. So the MACD and the stochastics at the same time. But let's say you were not quite ready. You know, you'd have to be a perfect trader just to know that this was going to make this cross. I'm not a perfect trader. Okay, so what you want to do is go ahead and let it cross. Why even guess? Okay, all you know is that this is crossed and you've already missed this. See, by the time this crosses, stochastics is already way over here on its way down. So you've already missed it, let's say, unless you had other clues. Maybe price is jumping off a resistance line or a pivot point or something. But let's just keep it simple. Let's just say that all you did was notice that the MACD is crossed down. Now you want to look for opportunities to short. You don't want to short now, because stochastics is so far sold, it's almost oversold, which means you're out of position, right? So this isn't a strategy that's going to give you every single pip and every single move. You're going to be late getting in, you're going to be late getting out, but you're going to get trade opportunities where price action and market action are aligned. So sometimes it's the vast majority or most of the move, but what we're looking for is conservative, repeatable trade setups that are likely to yield a profit. So let's say you're way late. You say to yourself, here, MACD is falling, so you want to look for opportunities to sell. Here's one here. Now, this isn't a good one, because it didn't rise very far, something kept it short. What's interesting is if you see these lines here, they're lines that represent 25% and 75% of this large range. Something kept the stochastics from rising back up. It's bearish, and as long as it's below this 25% level, it's going to stay bearish. And if everyone's selling, then of course it's bearish, right? So let's bring price back now and take a look at what happened. What is this, 45 minutes ago or an hour and a half ago? I guess these are 1 minute candles, guys, so I'm showing you 1 minute because it's moving really quickly. But I'm telling you, it works the same on a 15 minute, it works the same on an hour, it works the same on a 4 hour, it works the same in the daily, okay? I'm just showing you something that's happened in the last couple of hours, okay? Here's the MACD cross, right in here. Look at this. Something was extremely bearish on this and kept it down. Look at that. That means you're actually shorting somewhere in here, right? The other thing you can do is say, well, I would rather it rise farther, because if the stochastics is rise, let's say, to the 50% level, like here, which is about 50 or 60% level, then it has a farther to fall, right? Well, in this case, it was a few pips, only 25 or 30 pips by the time if you entered on this Stokes. But look at this. This extra bearishness actually put you in here. Now, for a millisecond, you were a little worried, but then it paid off. So you would have shorted at 63.35, and by the time this MACD crossed down in here, it was 66.05. So, you know, 30 pips or something like that. Hey, not amazing. I'm not trying to sell you some crystal ball or some magic method that's going to make you millions of pips. But I'm just saying, where what I'm showing you is, in somewhere in here, the market decided to fall. A conservative method would be to wait for price to fall too, which is here and here. Now, I'll tell you, today was an extremely unusual day where the markets were really tight. Okay, we didn't get the big ranges that that we're accustomed to. And this wasn't a fantastic trade opportunity. In the New York session today, I only pulled the trigger a couple of times. I'm showing you examples in an extremely mediocre trading day. I can go back to yesterday and the day before and the day before that and show you how much of a genius I was in those days. I'm showing you in the odd, tough, consolidated, range-bound, whatever market. And yet, you're still eking out a few pips here using this methodology. Okay, even on the tough, challenging days. And I'm not afraid to show you the tough, challenging days because I coach and trade every single day, good, bad, or ugly. Okay, let's take a look at something else. Pound dollar. Okay, let's do pound dollar. That's everybody loves a pound dollar, right? Let's open this this 1 minute chart up and let's take a look at what's been happening. Let's take a look. Here's a MACD cross right here, right? Right? That means up in here. Then there was a big move, and then right in here on price, you'll see that stochastic crossed. All right, new opportunity to sell. Now you missed this move, well, cry me a river. But right in here on this cross, you had stochastics lined up with MACD, which is falling, and you ended up shorting here. Okay, 116.17. And by the time, let's say, you got out, let's say, down in here, 160.80. Okay, well, that's better. That's over 100 pips. Okay? That's over 100 pips. Now, what's interesting is MACD started to rise right here. So what would you do? You'd go long here, and you're long here, and then you don't get a higher high in here, so you cash out. And so, yeah, so you only made 40 pips on that one, 110 pips down and 40 pips back up, just waiting to line up the MACD with stochastics. I mean, line up stochastics with MACD. Always let the MACD lead the way. Okay, the analogy I like to use is imagine you're dogfighting in a fighter plane, right? Well, the first thing you got to do is swoop your plane down behind the enemy because unfortunately your air-to-air missiles don't fly backwards, they don't fly sideways, which means you got to get your aircraft behind the enemy's aircraft first, okay? Then the next thing you got to do is lock your weapon systems on. If you ever watch Top Gun, that's where they go beep, 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 and then you go fire, and off goes the missile, right? That's what you're trying to do. First, you got to swoop in behind your target with MACD. And then once you got MACD behind the target, now you got to lock your weapon systems before you pull the trigger. And that's waiting for the stochastics to come around and point in the same direction and splash one bogey down. Okay, so let's. So there's a couple of opportunities. And again, I'm showing you tough days. I'm not showing you the perfect day. I'm showing you tough trading days. And there were opportunities using this. You want to do a cross? Let's do a cross pair. The oil moved a bit today, and the yen moved a lot today. So why don't we pick on something like a CAD yen? Now, when oil goes up, the Canadian dollar usually benefits, and then and the Japanese yen does not benefit. So let's just take a look. We had some crosses in here. Here's a MACD cross. There's your next stochastics. That means short right here. Nice potential. All of a sudden, you run out of lower lows, and a MACD crosses here. Okay, so you know in what 80. 8160 out at 8060. So there, 100 pip move. So now you got the cross here, and look at the next stochastic cross. That puts you long right about here. Again, about at 81. And then the MACD cross, which takes you out of that. So you're in at 81 out at 8217, 120 pips. And then here's a short after MACD's falling, and puts you up in here. Nothing happens, peters out, probably a break-even trade, and we're close to the end of the day. And then there's the last cross to make it over. So, you know, a couple opportunities there to make over 100 pips. And again, all you're doing is let MACD cross first, and then short on the Stokes cross, which is here. So this is your selling. And then MACD crosses back up, so you end that selling. You're not bearish anymore, you're bullish. So what you do is wait for the next stochastic cross up, which is right there, which puts you long right in here. MACD up here crosses, and which takes you out of that trade right in here somewhere. Okay, so you got all of this when you were bearish, and all of this when you're bullish. Not every single pip, but conservative, repeatable trading at its best. And I swear to you, on days where the market is rocking and rolling, this is a fantastic way to time your trading. Now, keep in mind, MACD and these oscillators, what they're showing you is not the overall move. You know what I'm saying this. You're looking at the moving averages to technically set up your trades. They're measuring past price action, okay? And once you've become bullish or bearish, you've set your bias, then what you're doing is you're actually refining your entries based on what the oscillators are doing, okay? So you can see that the 5/8 is crossing here, but you actually don't want to enter until the Stokes crosses. So very interesting, I think. A great way to fine-tune and hone your trades. You don't have to be too aggressive. See, aggressive traders would just trade simply because of the MACD cross, or just because of a 5/8 cross, or just because of this, that, or the other thing. What I'm saying to you is you can be extremely, extremely conservative. Let MACD cross first, and then ignore it. Okay? And then ignore it. Let me go back to the chart. And then ignore it, okay? Okay, there's the cross. Now look how long it took before you got the Stokes to cross. You know, 15, 20 minutes. And then you're shorting here. Okay, now you sacrificed some of the pips to be conservative, but you got the easy stuff, all right? This is nice and easy because now you have the two oscillators lined up. Same thing, MACD crossed way down in here. It didn't mean you had to know that was the 5/8 cross. How would you know? Bollinger Bands were closing, moving averages, the angle of separation on moving averages were diminishing. This was chop, 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 up and down. How are you supposed to know to go there, to go long there, especially if you were just short, taking out pips out of the market, and then all of a sudden you have to be a genius and flip the other way? Oh, well, Wayne says I should know these things. I need to be a perfect trader. Well, you know what? I'm not a perfect trader, okay? So, but I am a conservative trader, so I do see the MACD cross, and I say, aha, Geg Zeus, I can see that. I'm now bullish. So now I have to wait for the conservative repeatable trade setup based on when the stochastic crosses back up, I can go long. And here we go. It's oversold, crosses up. That puts me in here. Look at this. I had to sit on my hands for 45 minutes before I had an opportunity to go long. But you know what? Look at that. It was all right. That's all right. That's over 100 pips. Conservative, repeatable trading at its best. So I hope you practice this on a demo account. Okay? So once again, my name is Wayne McDonald. I'm the Chief Currency Coach of FXBootcamp.com. Thanks for attending this presentation for Daily FX. And once again, all the trade examples are from my live account on the FXCM MT4 platform.